Hello and welcome to the video tutorial for the PrestaShop Salesforce connector. This extension helps to integrate data between PrestaShop and Salesforce. It has option to select the manual sync and real-time synchronization of lead, customers, categories and orders. It helps to integrate data integrity and to provide services to the customers to the desired level. As coming to its features, it acts as a bridge between PrestaShop and Salesforce. It gives a concept of service-first approach. It can process a bulk data from PrestaShop to Salesforce and vice versa. Lightning feature supported and provide you an interactive design with a brilliant user interface. It syncs PrestaShop contact as Salesforce as leads and PrestaShop customers to Salesforce as accounts and contact. It would sync PrestaShop categories and products to Salesforce as custom categories and products respectively. It would sync PrestaShop orders to Salesforce order. It provides the real-time synchronization of leads, customers, categories and orders. It provides you an option to map order details and lead status. It provides compatibility with multi-currency and enabled org, as well as it provides you an option for default field mapping. It provides the synchronization of Salesforce products and orders to PrestaShop orders. In this, admin has to set default shipping and payment method. Even admin can select the default folder for documents and PrestaShop default price book for product price. As now, we have recently updated our plugin, so it is fully based on REST API using 2.0 authorization, and it provides easy, fast and secure setup for the user. So this is all about the features of this application. So let's proceed to install this application in Salesforce org. For this, you have to enter the eShop sync for PrestaShop at the AppExchange. We just need to click on Get It Now, or even you can see all the details related to the application. You can see all the details related to the application in this section. Now you just need to click on Get It Now. So if you want to install this application in production, then click on install in production. Otherwise, you can also install it in sandbox. So we can proceed to install in production. Just need to click on the terms and condition and confirm install. So click on install for all users and click on install. Now, as you can see that the application was installed successfully, now click on Done. You can see that the application was installed successfully, and you can see that it was appeared in the install package sections. So now, the first thing you have to do after installation of eShop Sync for PrestaShop, first you need to update the field accessibility for all the custom fields created by this application. So you need to go through this blog and you need to update all the mentioned fields of this application. So you need to update the field accessibility of the following objects. You just need to update the field accessibility for the leads, contacts, products and orders. So as you can see that it would allow the synchronization process to fetch the details related to the application data. So let's proceed to install the connector at the PrestaShop and configure it accordingly. So this is our PrestaShop backend. We just need to click on Modules Manager. We just need to upload a module by click on Upload on Module. you have to upload the CIV which you have got while purchasing the application. You just need to select the file, click on the zip and click on open. Once it was installed, it would show a successfully message. So here you can see that module was installed successfully. Now you just need to configure it accordingly. So as you can see that the application has installed successfully at the PrestaShop end. So you just need to connect your Salesforce production. You have to provide the allow access. So here you can see that the all information was connected with the Salesforce org, and you can see all the information here in the org ID. You can see the name, email and username. So once you have installed the application, you have to set it up few more things, like you have to select the folder in which you want to install the images of the products and categories. You have to select the price book if you have created a new one apart from the standard one. You have to select the address according to your requirement, as well as for the real-time sync, you can enable the real-time sync option for this, the leads for the customers, categories and order. So here you can set the real-time synchronization. Once you have configured it according to requirement, you can save it, or you can set the guest account from this pick list. You can set the guest account and you can set the main account if you don't want to sync the contact to individual account. So here you can set the configuration according to your requirement and click on save once you have done with the configuration. So now let's proceed through the synchronization of data. First, we will proceed to the synchronization of customers. Now click on sync customers. Here you can see all the list of the customers. So you just need to click on the customers, or you can select all the customers and you just need to click on exported selected customers. So here you can see that all the customers were synchronized successfully. Here you can see that the options. So once the customer was synchronized successfully, you can see that the message that all was synchronized successfully. So let's proceed at the Salesforce end. So here you can see all the list of the customers which were synchronized from PrestaShop to Salesforce end. So now let's proceed to the synchronization of the products. So for synchronization of the product, you just need to select the product and you just need to select the export selected products. And here you can see that all the selected product was synchronized from PrestaShop to Salesforce. Even you can see that the ID was generated while clicking while pasting on this ID at the Salesforce, and you can see all the details related to the products. So now let's proceed to see the information at the Salesforce end. At the Salesforce end, you can see all the three products which were synchronized from PrestaShop to Salesforce. Here you can see all the three products. Even here you can see select the price book according to a requirement. You can see all the, you can set the product option if you want to select to show all the products, and if you want to select the PrestaShop products. Here you can select the categories of the product which you want to see the product categories of specific products. So here you can, from this section you can select these categories. So now let's proceed to sync the orders. So for synchronizing the orders, you can select the orders. And you just need to export selected orders. So here you can see that all the order was synchronized successfully from PrestaShop to Salesforce, and you can see that all the ID was generated. So we can proceed to see all the orders at the Salesforce end. So here you can see that all the order was synchronized successfully at the Salesforce end. From this section, you can select the choice of your orders. If you want to show the Salesforce order, you can select the Salesforce order. That way you can select the PrestaShop orders. So this is all about the synchronization for the orders. So you can sync few other option. You can synchronize all the contact us as a leads to Salesforce. Here you can see all the contact us was synchronized as a leads to the Salesforce, and here you can see that the ID was generated too. So you can find that the contact us response has been synchronized as leads in Salesforce. So now we have few options as well as for mapping the order details. You can set the shipping method by clicking on add it. You can select the required option and click on save. You can add the payment method name and you can save it. So this is all about the mapping all details. Even you can add map, and you can select all the possible mapping thing available over here. Just need to click on save and you have mapped the order status. Also you can map the lead status. You can change and click on the change status mapping. So this is all about the functionality of the application PrestaShop Salesforce Connector. So we have synchronized the things in the Salesforce Lightning view at our connector, and it is also supportable at the Classic view as well. So let's proceed to the synchronization at the Classic view. So this is the interface of the Salesforce Classic view. Here you can see all the contacts us which was synchronized as a lead to the Salesforce end. You can see all the products which was synchronized from PrestaShop to Salesforce end. Here you can see all the products. You can see all the categories as well as orders. And customers. So once you go to the configuration, you will easily manage your synchronization configuration part, and also you may click on the user guide with all the details. Here you can see all the steps for configuring the application, the Lightning and the Classic view. Even you can find all the related links for configuring the application, the Lightning and the Classic. So this is all about the installation and the configuration of the PrestaShop Salesforce Connector. Thanks for watching this video.